Good evening. This is Left, Right and Center. I'm Nidhi Razdan. Tonight, Netas rush to Faridabad where Dalit children are burnt alive. Will the family get justice? Will the political blame game help anyone? Also tonight, how Mensa, the world's most prestigious high IQ society, is mentoring poor and extremely gifted children in India. Many of these children belong to very underprivileged families, but their stories are inspiring and incredible. They'll be joining us in the studio later tonight. But first, the big story today. Heartbreaking scenes of the dead bodies of two toddlers burnt alive by a suspected upper caste group when they were set on fire yesterday morning in their own home. Their deaths have sparked off an ugly political blame game today. Rahul Gandhi went to meet the family and then got visibly angry when a reporter asked him if this was a photo opportunity. The Aam Aadmi Party and the CPM landed up as well. Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar cancelled his visit and has now ordered a CBI probe.
A gut-wrenching sight as two infants, 11 months and 2 years old, first victims of a caste feud, are now at the center of a political blame game.
मैं उनको कहीं ना जाने दूंगा मैं यही रखूंगा अपने पास मैं नहीं जान दूंगा उनको
Relatives picketed on the Faridabad-Ballabgarh highway for hours until a lathi charge broke it up. They were demanding action against the upper caste villagers who allegedly set fire to the hut where the two infants were sleeping with their parents. Overnight, Sunped village in Haryana has become a political battleground, though some denied it was a photo op.
उन्होंने मुझसे सवाल पूछा कि हमने क्या गलती की बात सिर्फ ये है कि वो गरीब हैं कमजोर हैं इसलिए उन पे अत्याचार हुआ है गरीब लोग दबाए जा रहे हैं मारे जा रहे हैं दिस इज एन एटीट्यूड शेयर्ड बाय द प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड द चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ द स्टेट द एटीट्यूड इज दैट इफ समबडी इज वीक ही कैन बी क्रश्ड डाइंग लेफ्ट राइट एंड सेंटर इन दिस कंट्री पीपल आर बीइंग बीटन अप इन दिस कंट्री व्हाट डू यू मीन इट्स एन ओपन फोटो ऑप Yes, absolutely, I will visit. I will visit again and again and again.
Some, of course, like the chief minister himself, postponed visiting the village. His aide saying it was to give time to the family to carry out the last rites of the children. But with the entire issue being politicized, especially in view of the ongoing Bihar elections, the BJP government at the state and center are now on the back foot, under attack even from an ally.
जो कुछ भी इस प्रकार की घटनाएं हो रही हैं बहुत ही दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण है बहुत ही निंदनीय है नहीं होनी चाहिए और संबंधित राज्य के मुख्यमंत्री से हमारी बातचीत हुई है
टोटली राज्य सरकार की जवाबदेही होती है लॉ एंड ऑर्डर का जो मामला है हालांकि शेड्यूल कास्ट शेड्यूल ट्राइब्स का जो है हम लोग कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोटेक्शन है लेकिन जो ये जो पूरा का पूरा मामला है राज्य सरकार का
The state has arrested 4 of the alleged attackers and suspended 8 policemen who were missing on the night of the attack. They were supposed to have been outside the Dalit family's house as they had been for the past year. After a feud between the upper caste and Dalits had led to the death of 3 Thakurs and the imprisonment of 3 members of Jitinder's family. But that night, Jitinder says the policemen were at some nearby function and didn't respond to his cries for help. The BJP on the back foot has now ordered a CBI probe into the matter to assuage tempers. But from what we are hearing from villagers, small speeches being made at the house, the protests seem to be continuing. They want the protest to continue even if the national highway is not to be blocked. And can the family really forget that horrible night when their 2 children were burnt alive in this very house? From campus in Mohammed Arif, Pairavi Singh, NDTV.
Well, it's become a political battleground, but will this family actually end up getting justice for what has happened? Joining us tonight, Professor Kantra Elaya, well-known Dalit writer and activist, joining us this evening from Hyderabad. Ejaz Ilmi of the BJP back with us this evening. Kumari Selja, a former minister and leader of the Congress Party, and Manoj Jha from the RJD joining us tonight from Patna. We'll be joined shortly by other panelists as well. But Professor Elaya, let me ask you first, isn't it a shame that something like this still happens in this country and it has happened, you know, a stone's throw from the national capital?
Nidhi, this is surprising. On the one hand, BJP, RSS and its allied organizations have been saying that we will work towards removal of this untouchability, we will take them into temples, we will do this and that, but Look at the way these people, this whole house got burnt down in a government that got elected very recently, and one of their pracharaks is heading that government. Now this is absolutely shameful, as you said, and I think the whole nation has to stand up and condemn this. The whole nation has to fight against this kind of brutality. Now where are we going from one after the other, lynching, beef, killing Dalits, and there was another Dalit who was burnt alive when he was entering into a temple in UP. Now I think this is becoming absolutely brutal.
Well, very strong words from you there, Kanchalaya. And Ejaz, let me first come to this particular incident that has happened in Faridabad. Would you concede that there has been an utter failure of the Haryana police to protect this family, given that there were actually police that were, you know, deployed in this village for the past year or so? There was a caste history here, as it were, because of a similar attack that took place a year ago. Was this a complete and utter failure of the police?
The fact that they were under police protection for a year's time and the police was not available when they were attacked shows that there was dereliction of duty. And that is one of the prime reasons that a CBI inquiry has been ordered, because when there are question marks on the people who are supposed to give protection, so there should be no doubt that the government, this union government and the BJP government in Haryana asked for it. You can't have question marks on something so horrific and something so tragic as burning alive of two toddlers, as you say. But it's also imperative to understand that investigations can only be done correctly because this matter has been in the court. The police was found derelicting their own duties, and despite suspensions, the tragedy is so monumental that only a proper investigation into why something like this happened can bring justice to the bereaved family.
Well, Kumari Seljaz, then let me ask you, at least the Haryana government has ordered a CBI probe. They have suspended 8 policemen who you know, for dereliction of duty. What more can you expect the state government to do at this point?
I think we are just trying to minimize the situation and the incident. It is much larger than what has happened. It is not just a matter of giving justice to one family. See the way the atmosphere was built up in this village, in the whole state. Why is it that people feel, some people feel, belonging to certain strata of society, that they can do anything, they can commit any crime and they can get away with it, even while there was supposedly police protection for the weaker sections? Why was it that it happened? Theek hai, they will order, the state government under pressure will order CBI inquiry or try to give some kind of succor to these people, to the Dalits. But I think it goes much deeper than that, and it's not just the police department. Dereliction of duty of few police personnel, let us not minimize that. It is the whole environment created by this BJP government in not just my state but in the country, that people feel that they can do anything with impunity.
I want to go across to Om Prakash Dhankar, who's the agriculture minister of Haryana and is joining us on the OB tonight from Gurgaon. Dhankar ji, aap mujhe ye bataiye ki abhi Congress party ne kaha hai ki aapki sarkar ne theek hai pressure mein aake CBI ka probe order kiya hai, लेकिन वो कह रहे हैं कि ये एक इंसिडेंट की बात नहीं है, इस इंसिडेंट की बात नहीं है, ये एक माहौल है जिसमें ऐसे, मतलब हम ऐसे इंसिडेंट्स देख रहे हैं जिसमें ये एक और वाक्य सामने आ रहा है. धनकर जी,
देखिए, कांग्रेस तो पहले ये बताए, मिर्जपुर में 18 घर जले थे, कांग्रेस पहले उसका उत्तर दे. गोहाना में घर जले थे, उसका उत्तर दे. कितनी घटनाएं, दौलतपुर की घटना है, कितनी घटनाएं कांग्रेस के जमाने में हुई, कांग्रेस उन घटनाओं का पहला उत्तर देवे. पगाना गांव की घटना है, उसका उत्तर देवे. कांग्रेस के समय में कभी भी राहुल जी ने कभी इस्तीफा नहीं मांगा हुड्डा साहब का. अब ये किस तरह की राजनीति कर रहे हैं? यहां कोई किसी प्रकार का, इस प्रकार का सोच से साथ ये काम नहीं हुआ. सबको मालूम है कि ये घटना रंजिशन हुई है, दो परिवारों का झगड़ा था. पहले भी इसमें जो है लोग जेल में हैं, हत्याएं हुई हैं, और इसमें एक फेलियर जो आप अभी चर्चा कर रहे थे, पुलिस ने जिस तरह से प्रोटेक्ट करना था नहीं किया, तो इसलिए सरकार ने तुरंत सीबीआई जांच कर दी है, सबको सस्पेंड कर दिया है. जांच में दोषी पाए जाएंगे तो उनको भी सजा होगी, कोई भी उसमें बक्सा नहीं जाएगा. सरकार पूरी तरह से इस घटना को दुखद मानती है, दुर्भावनापूर्ण मानती है और परिवार के प्रति सैंपथेटिक है। मैं अभी बच्चों के संस्कार पर मैं और रामबिलास जी, कृष्ण पाल जी, हम सब लोग जाकर आए हैं। हम एक निवेदन करते हैं कि यहां आकर राजनीतिक रोटियां मत सेकिए, ये उस प्रकार की घटना नहीं है। किसी चीजों को, कुछ चीजों को बचने देना चाहिए। शांतिपूर्ण प्रदेश है, यहां आग लगाने नहीं आए राहुल जी, ये निवेदन करना चाहते हैं उनसे।
नहीं, मगर डंकर जी आप मुझे ये बताइए कि जो आपके पार्टी के एलाई हैं रामविलास पासवान, आज उन्होंने बोला कि जो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है ये स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की रिस्पांसिबिलिटी है, लॉ एंड ऑर्डर स्टेट गवर्नमेंट का है एंड ये जो हुआ है ये स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की रिस्पांसिबिलिटी है। ये तो आपके एलाई हैं बिहार में, मैं तो राहुल गांधी की बात ही नहीं कर रही। आप इसको लेकर क्या कहेंगे?
निश्चित रूप से कहीं भी कानून व्यवस्था राज्य सरकार की जिम्मेवारी है, कोई भी बताएगा, मुझे भी पूछेंगे तो यही बताऊंगा। हर जगह राज्य सरकार को ही कानून व्यवस्था को देखना होता है। कानून व्यवस्था में कहीं कमी आई है, पुलिस वाले कहीं दोषी पाए गए हैं तो तुरंत उनको सस्पेंड किया गया है, सीबीआई को जांच सौंपी गई है, कोई दिक्कत होगी जिस प्रकार की उन्होंने जो भी गलतियां की उनकी सजा मिलेगी।
So let me ask Manoj Jha then of the RJD, because Manoj Jha, this is an issue that has already percolated down to the election campaign in Bihar. But as the minister says from Haryana, are there some issues in which we should just keep politics out of it? And you know, in the sake of the interests of everyone involved, take a step back and have a humanitarian view rather than a political view. Manoj Jha.
Nidhi, I wish I could trust the expression of my friend from the minister from Haryana. I mean, the kind of images they have thrown in the public domain in last few days. I think I'm in Patna, I can tell you, Nidhi, even in the streets, when I was talking to some people randomly, they were so disturbed by the images which came from Haryana. You know why? There is an element of continuity from what Mr. Bhagwat said. Then I give you two instances, give me some time. And leave aside Bhagwat ji, give him a benefit of doubt. Guruji Golwalkar wrote a book, Bunch of Thoughts. He said caste-based reservation should be done away with. Dalits have no right to enter a temple if they declare that they are Dalit. Now you have these kind of images. Mr. Prime Minister himself wrote a book, Karma Yoga, where he said Dalits by doing scavenging, carrying dirt, they derive spiritual pleasure. This book was published in 2007. The earlier was in 2000. Now people see an element of continuity in the politics of Sangh and BJP. Forgive me, I don't want to blame directly on my behalf. People find a sense of continuity in their politics. They believe that their life is not secured with this anti-backward, anti-Dalit politics. Somehow the government at the center, they have not been able to manage the images of hate and intolerance, which has become hallmark. I don't know why, in last 2 months, we have been dwarfed as a nation, dwarfed as people. We have fallen several ladders on civilization. I think these are important messages. And this is certainly, Bihar is disturbed, the Dalits and the backwards in Bihar, they feel somehow that the entire policy is to do away with the constitutional provision. And they don't even have
that's
a right
a very strong statement
life.
To
that's
make.
A specious, fallacious
that's
lie.
That's a very strong Manoj, statement to make.
You are creating a specter that the constitution is out to be violated time and again. It's an imaginary thing on being asked to step back and look at it humanitarianly. You're playing abject politics and you're trying to inject the virus across the board. You have to step back and understand it's a humanitarian issue. Do not play politics by speaking out of context and quoting out of context. But the fact is, your silence,
Nidhi,
that why should there not be a CBI inquiry into Akhlaq's
Nidhi,
murder and Mr. Kalburgi's murder? I would ask for that demand because your allies, because the people
Nidhi,
parties close to you
Nidhi,
are ruling those states.
Manoj,
but your silence, your selective silence and selective
Nidhi,
outrage shows the kind of politics you want to play.
Manoj,
you have to step back.
Is this a sweeping generalization
Nidhi,
that
Nidhi,
you made of the BJP's
Nidhi,
politics?
Nidhi, I gave you reference, please check. And I own that in public domain. Number two, Nidhi, I did not put words in the mouth of Mr. Modi, the Prime Minister. My party did not put words in the mouth of Mr. Bhagwat. We did not put words in the mouth of Mr. Golwalkar. And please forgive me, we are not doing politics. We are simply disturbed with these kind of images. Why people are returning awards? What Dadri has done to our image as a nation? We, in spite of fighting, in spite of everything, we had an image of a tolerant nation, living together peacefully. What has happened to our national narrative. It has been disturbed. I mean, Mr. Prime Minister should realize that he has to live by constitution, Samvidhan, not Sangh ka Vidhan.
You're trying to create a sense of selective and complete amnesia as nothing happened in this country under your rule and various rules, and everything has started now. So the historical context and the political context has to match, which is why I told you, don't be selective and don't try and lull the entire nation into complete amnesia as to what happened in Lakshmanpur Baithe, what happens in Miapur under Lalu Prasad Yadav's regime. We understand these
who
things.
Who did that?
You did not.
Ranveer Sena did that.
Then who banned it? The BJP along with Nitish Kumar banned it. You did not ban
BJP.
It. You did not ban it in 2005.
Ranveer Sena was created
Nitish,
by BJP.
Nitish Kumar along with the BJP under our pressure, we said justice has to be done to the Dalits. That's why it was banned.
Okay, let me ask Professor Kanchal Iyer though, and we also have Professor Rakesh Sinha of the RSS joining us as well. Professor Kanchal Iyer, that do you agree? How do you look at this incident then? Is it a random incident? In this case, as Mr. Dhankar also rightly pointed out, you had a history of a caste feud, you know, in this particular village. There was security that was there for about a year, and clearly, you know, there were tensions that were building up, and that's not unique to Faridabad. It happens in many other parts of the country. Or do you think, as Manoj Jha says, that this is part of a larger narrative of intolerance that this country is seeing? How do you look at it?
No, Nidhi, the question is that there is an ideology of RSS, BJP, Vishwa Hindu Parishad, that they want to sustain the caste system, and they own up all the literature that wants to divide and keep the nation perpetually on caste lines. Take for example, all this happening in one state, the other, banning of beef, and then putting up one after the other, and you know, Vishwa Hindu Parishad, the direct organization, put a case on me for writing a very social reform article in a Telugu paper, and I had to go to High Court. See, there is this history. Now, why I am not immediately, you know, comparing this with the Congress? Congress ideologically did not do this. There could have been, there are number of incidents, yes, Congress period also, incidents happened, burning happened, so on and so forth. But the political position of the party was different. And the wings of these parties do not work like that. Here is a network which has absolutely negative ideology towards Dalits, towards Adivasis, towards Muslims, and the attack takes place on that. This is a problem. And the whole nation is being blamed. All over the world, however Narendra Modi ji goes abroad and asks for investments, they don't come in this atmosphere. You just understand.
Okay,
this
let me take this to Professor Rakesh Sinha.
I think that we should see these issues beyond politics. And I would like to remind Kanchan Elahi and others that Mahatma Gandhi was the one person in 1933, he started 1 year Harijan campaign in this country. He toured 12,000 kilo miles in this country and collected 8 lakh rupees for the upliftment of the Harijans. Second thing, as far as RSS and BHP is concerned, it is not the time to discuss RSS and BHP, but I will remind two incidents. In 1969, for the first time in the history of India, all the religious figures from all the sects got together in Udupi, that is known as the Udupi resolution, that was inspired by Sri Golwalkar, RSS chief. And they passed the resolution that religious leaders should act for removing untouchability. So, and the foundation of Ram Janmabhoomi by Kameswar Chapale Harijan. So, I'm not going to that narrative. What I say, that these are the issues we should address beyond politics. As I say, in Haryana, there's a 245% increase of crime on Harijan atrocities in the Congress regime. It's not a question of Congress. And I will say there are 51,000 atrocities on Harijan in 2014, 9,000 in Uttar Pradesh. So it is not the case of the BJP, Congress, RSS or Samajwadi Party. It is the case of feudalism in the villages. So we have to fight feudalism and casteism together. If the nation doesn't take collective responsibility for that, if you will keep fighting on the basis of political basis, then we are not going to resolve any issue like the Dalit issue. So Dalit question is a separate issue.